Hey y'all, my name is Samantha. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am doing a makeup collection video today. This video was requested by Madison. So Madison, if you're banded, come on in. Join the party. Madison, if you're watching this, then here you go. But if y'all are interested in watching and seeing everything that I have, just continue watching. So this is the whole setup. I got a chair with cacti on it. Then my rug down there, it fits perfectly. So this is just like an office desk that my boyfriend's aunt gave me. And it works great. And I do like that it's gloss on top. That way you can see the palettes. But this is like an overview. So we're going to start in the windowsill itself. In here we have just lotion, my extra tripods, my lens, a microphone. This right here, this bag is, I think there were like Harry Potter brushes in there, but I've never used them. But I just keep them there because I don't like to use them. Over here we got baby wipes. I use that to remove makeup sometimes. And then we have these facial wipes. I got the mask right there. I have a teddy bear with that headband on it, and then a little badminton birdie. So this right here is my jewelry box. Everything that I keep up here is my setting powder. I have this little mini Bath and Body Works hand sanitizer. I've got this Wet n Wild primer. Then I've got the Wet n Wild foundation. Got the Revlon Color Stay foundation as well. Then another Bath and Body Works lotion. And then I got the Morphe setting spray up here. In here, I'll just show you what's makeup related. This is where I keep my eyelash curler. This is where I keep my face makeup at. I keep a little mouthwash cup full of Q-tips right there. In this first drawer, I usually keep my main things that I use every day. So I've got the Wet n Wild Max Volume Mascara. Got this Katy Perry mascara. Next, I got the Maybelline New York Brow Drama Sculpting Gel. This is the Unique Moodstruck Epic Mascara Black Waterproof. This is the Revlon Color Stay Liquid Eye Pen. This is LA Color Precise Eye Marker. The NYX Eyeliner. The NYX Epic Eyeliner. Ink Eyeliner. This is the Wet n Wild Retractable Brow Pencil. A Maybelline Fit Me in Ivory or 5 Ivory. I got this in here. I don't know why. It's the LA Colors Brow Pencil. But it's honestly, like, it's got this much left. I'm actually just going to go ahead and throw it away. I don't use it anymore anyway. I've got these eyelashes that just stay in there for some reason. I've got the Maybelline tweezers. This is like one of those little pimple popper thingies. It's got the sharp point at the end. Got an eyeliner sharpener. And then I have two eyeshadow primers. It's really dirty in this drawer because of the eyeliner. But this is all that's in the first one besides this Q-tip. So, in this next drawer, I have got this LA Colors Workshop Blush. A bunch of the makeup that I use is usually the LA Colors makeup because it all came in this pack like a while ago, like a very long time ago. This is the CoverGirl White Eyeshadow. I actually bought this just for the eyeshadow look that I did for last 4th of July because I didn't have any good white eyeshadows. So I used this one, but I haven't used it since. I've got this LA Colors Conceal Correct. I got this for my birthday. I haven't used it yet, but if y'all want to see what else I got for my birthday, for my 20th birthday, click the little eye that's in the corner of your screen. This is the LA Colors Conceal It. I haven't used this in a while, but I keep it just for backup in case I either run out or I need something else to cut my crease or something. I don't know, but I got this. We have this Beauty Inside lip gloss little pan thing. I don't know. I've only ever used this one and this one, and it's literally just to swatch it to see what they looked like. Other than that, I haven't ever used it, but I don't know. I just keep it anyway. I don't know why I don't throw things away. A little bit of a hoarder. I've got two chapsticks. I have the Carmex Strawberry Chapstick, and then I have a Blistex chapstick. We've got the NYX Glitter Primer. We've got another Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, but this one is in 10 Fair. I wish that this would focus. Came in a set of like makeup thing that I got for Christmas one year with this. I think it was last year or 2 years ago. Next, this is the highlighter that I use every time that I do my makeup, and this is the Wet n Wild highlighter in Blossom Glow. This is literally so pretty. If y'all have not ever used Wet n Wild's highlighter, I definitely recommend it. This is the LA Colors Illuminating Powder. It's just a highlight as well. Then we have these two Color Workshop eyeshadow palettes. I have never used this one. I've never used this one. And then this one I've only ever used for the black shade for my Halloween makeup video that I actually have posted on my channel. It's my very first channel or my very first video, and it actually is horrible quality. So maybe next time I will just recreate it. And then I have this Duo Eyeshadow Adhesive. So that's all in this drawer. Let's go to the next one. In this very last drawer, I've got a pair of eyelashes. I've got this Beauty Insight Blush. I've never used this either. I have this Revlon Color Stay Cream Eyeshadow. This is my remote to my lamp over here. This is an old product. I'm assuming that it's from the Beauty Insight brand as well, because it's the same kind of packaging. But this is for eyebrows. And we have this NYX Glitter. This is super pretty. Next, I got a pair of scissors. I've got these tweezers. I just literally about called this Twizzlers, but it's just another set of tweezers. I have these three, what are they called? Like eyebrow shavers? Face shavers? Something like that. Then I've got this old LA Colors liquid eyeliner. I haven't used this in, I don't even know how long. It looks like this. Let's see if it'll focus. And the last two things that I have over here is the Color Workshop glitters. I have a like goldy color and a silver color. I love these glitters. They're so pretty. And that is it in this drawer. Next, what I have is all of my eyeshadow brushes in this cute little cat cup that I got for Christmas. A lot of these are stained with pigment. They're not dirty. I do clean my brushes about once a week, maybe once every 2 weeks. So, yeah, those are pretty much stained by the pigments. I have my little mirror here. Both of my mirrors are very dirty, as you can see. You can see everything on there. And then going forward, this is my deodorant, obviously. I have the Katy Perry Indie Fragrance Mist perfume. This Reverie by Rihanna perfume is literally so freaking good smelling. And I need more. Like, it's so empty, it's not even funny. But I'm keeping it so that I remember to get more. This one is In the Stars by Bath & Body Works. Warm Vanilla by Bath & Body Works. And then Suki from Burks, but I don't know where to get more, but it smells really good too. Thing on top of the desk is my lamp that changes colors, and then my hairbrush. Over here I do keep my big tripod and then my battery charger. So, now it is the time for my eyeshadow palettes. So I put y'all on the big tripod, that way it's easier for me to see. But this is the bottom part. We're just gonna pull it out. So when you pull it out, this is what you see. In this little part where I guess you would keep your pens and pencils, things like that, because once again this was like a desk. I put my lipsticks here. So we first have this LA Colors matte purple lipstick. Well, it's like a pinky purple. I don't think that I've ever worn this. I think I've swatched it, but that's about all that's ever happened. We have this extremely old Color Workshop red lipstick. This lip gloss that I have no idea where it came from. There's nothing on here, but it's super pretty. It's not that pink as it looks in camera on the lips. This, once again, I have no idea what brand it is, where it came from, anything like that. I know that I got it from my Nana a long time ago. It's just a liquid lipstick, but it's in this really pretty, like, brownish red color. Next, this and that perfume over there came together. This is the Katy Perry Matte in Tricot Giraffes. I believe that's how you say it. It's in KP10. And I've worn this in videos before too. It is such a pretty color. Then I've got this LA Colors Matte Liquid Lipstick. It's really pretty. It honestly reminds me of this one, the Mannequin Shade of Jeffree Star. But it's really pretty. And then I have the matching lip pencil to go with. For some reason in here I've got this little Too Faced angled brush. Next I have the Milani lipstick in Pink Frost. Got a little hot, that's why it's melted. Don't leave things in your car, people. Wet n Wild lipstick in Sangria Time. I believe I said that right. It's this pretty purple in the tube, but once you put it on, it's not the prettiest. Like, I don't know, it looks more like a lip gloss or something on your lips, and I don't like it. I like more of the solid, like, vibrant colors. We have the Jeffree Star X Morphe lipstick in the shade Mannequin. Really pretty. This is what I'm wearing today. We have the gloss and First Impression. We've got this Wet n Wild. This is limited edition. I believe it, yeah. I'm pretty sure this was one of the limited edition Wet n Wild lip glosses. It was with the Amethyst Crystal Collection. Then we have the Sexy Mother Pucker lipstick in a very, very vibrant pink shade. I somehow managed to shove it down in there and it crushed the tip, but it's very pretty, to believe it or not. We've got another liquid lipstick from Jeffree Star in the shade Leo. This one's really pretty too. The very last one that I have to show that's on this is the RK by Kiss matte lipstick. It's in this pretty purple. It's like a very dark purple, but I feel like it wasn't that dark. Oh, well, yeah, that's pretty dark purple. That's what it looks like. I think it's pretty, but I have a tendency to buy things and never wear them or try them out or things like that. That's what this is. Going forward, we're going to start with this. This is a Morphe bag, and it's full of my beauty blenders or beauty sponges, whatever you want to call it. There's quite a few in there. This is where I keep my beauty sponges. I have this LA Colors Face Strobing Palette. I have actually never used any of these shades. This one, when I bought it, it actually came shattered and it was everywhere in the palette, hence everything. And I was actually able to save it with that alcohol trick and put it back in there. But other than that, I've never actually used any of these shades. So that was a waste of, I think it was like $10 for all these, which isn't bad, but I probably shouldn't have bought it because I knew I wasn't gonna use it. This right here is from, okay, I don't know who makes this. I think it's like LA Colors or, I don't know. I don't know who makes this. I got this for a Christmas present 2 or 3 years ago. I've never actually really used this palette. I don't know why. I just don't ever gravitate to it. And it's got so many pretty shades in there. But I just feel like it's probably not going to be that pigmented. I have dipped into this shade before because it's just like a very pretty goldy color. But other than that, I haven't really used it. But it is so pretty. It's got all the colors that you would need. I don't reach for this palette. I should probably actually give it to someone else. But I haven't thrown it away or given it to anybody else because it was a present. And I feel really bad for throwing or giving away presents. So that's why you keep it. And so its place is right here forever until it's expired and I have no choice but to throw it away. Moving on. This is the Shane Dawson and Jeffree Star Conspiracy Palette. Everybody and their mama knows about this palette, so don't have to give it an introduction. Here is what it looks like. It is super, super pretty. I believe I have a video up on my channel about this palette, if you want to go watch that. Next is the Revolution Cannabis Stiva palette. Let me tell y'all, I love this packaging. It's like a 10, and I love it so much. I don't know why, but, and it's very pretty. I don't smoke marijuana, but I thought that it was pretty, and I really like the shades, so I was going to buy it anyway. This is what it looks like, and I love green eyeshadow, so that's also another reason why I got it. Why is it so crooked? Are y'all crooked? I think y'all might be off-centered. Hello? But this is what it looks like. Super pretty. I have a video up on my channel with this as well. This shade is so, so pretty. If you want to go check that out, it's on here somewhere. If I can find the video, I'll put it in the little eye. Next is this pretty baby. This I freaking love. I love the filling of it. I love everything about this palette. I love colored eyeshadow. Like green, blue, and purple are my favorite eyeshadow looks ever. But this one right here is the Jeffree Star Bloodlust palette. And this is what it looks like. I was actually going to use this on my eyes today, but I chose not to. I did a simple look, but it is so stinking pretty. And I had a good idea, like, what if we do, like, this color and this one with, like, maybe this on the inner corner and this on the waterline. I think that would be so pretty. But This is what it looks like. Moving on. This is the Revolution X Alex Stone Instinct Palette. Heads up with this palette. I think that it is so freaking gorgeous, and I love this palette so much because, like I just said, I love colored eyeshadows, but the majority of these colors in here are pressed pigments, aka something that's going to stain your brushes and stain your face. So be careful with what you use, but other than that, I love this palette. I did a tie-dye look one time on my eye with this palette, and I'll put pictures up on the screen, but that video was so freaking hard to film, so it never became a video. But this is a really, really pretty palette. Next, I have the Jaclyn Hill X Morphe palette. Like, everybody has this palette. The one thing that I have stressed on and said so many times in my videos are I hate that all the shade names are on the back. I cannot stand that in a makeup palette. But that's what I have to say, because there's plenty enough room to fit little labels down here saying what the names are. But other than that, this palette is so good. What I'm wearing now is this palette. It's the shade, and then this one. And I just think that is so pretty. But this is also a pretty good palette. My last two palettes are the same palette. It is both the Morphe X James Charles palettes. This is obviously the big one, and this is the mini one. I have never actually used the mini palette. It's just I wanted it, so I got it. But this is what it looks like. This is the mini one. I believe that TJ actually bought this one for me. I'm almost certain he did. But I've never even swatched this palette because, let's be honest, I already know what it is. I know how it works. But I just haven't ever used it because it's going to be like my backup one. And yeah. But this is that. And then the very last one is, of course, the big one. I've used this one a lot. I do like to keep my palettes a little more clean, and that's why it's like barely dirty. Of course, they're not the cleanest, but you know, I don't like when you see some people's palettes, how they're so messy and there's like fallout and kickback everywhere. I can't stand that, so that's why the majority of them are pretty clean. This shade right here is pretty good for my eyebrow color, so that's what I use it for, and then I use this one for my contour. But my favorite part about this palette itself is the blue category. I can make a really good looking blue eyeshadow, so this is what this one looks like. So yeah, that is all of my makeup and my little tour thing, minus the tripod that y'all were just on, and the trash that I have collected. So this is all the makeup that I have on my desk and things that I usually grab for. I am also now subscribed to Ipsy, so I will be getting packages every month from them, so it will slowly grow from that as well. Alright, but this is the end of the video, so if you like the video, then like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, comments, or video ideas, comment down below and let me know. But follow me on TikTok. It's right here. It should be right here. Wait, flipped. So it should be like right here, I think. Either right here or right here. One or the other. I think it's right here. But anyway, it's Samantha_Green4. So if you want to go see my TikToks, my embarrassing TikToks, go ahead and watch those. Anyway, till next time, peace out.